Hi, I'm Cathy with Level Up RN. In this video, I'm going to wrap up my coverage of integumentary system medications. Specifically, I will be covering medications for psoriasis, for acne, and to treat lice and scabies. Be sure to stay until the end of the video because I will be giving you guys a quiz to test your knowledge of some of the key concepts I'll be covering in this video. If you have our pharmacology flashcards, definitely pull those out so you can follow along with me. Let's start by talking about topical agents which can be used in the treatment of psoriasis. So we previously talked about some systemic agents which are effective against psoriasis, including cyclosporin and methotrexate. Here we're just talking about topical agents. So three different medications I'd be familiar with include coal tar, salicylic acid, and topical corticosteroids. So coal tar is used to help slow the growth of skin cells, and it helps to decrease itching and inflammation as well. Side effects can include photosensitivity, staining of clothes, and at high doses, it does carry an increased risk for cancer. Salicylic acid helps to soften and remove the scales associated with psoriasis. Side effects include mild burning and stinging. And then topical corticosteroids are often used for psoriasis as well. These agents help to decrease the patient's immune response and decrease inflammation as well. Side effects are usually pretty mild, but can include burning, itching, or irritation. Next, let's talk about some medications that are used to treat acne. So we have some topical antibiotic agents, which include benzoyl peroxide, as well as topical clindamycin. These medications can cause dryness and skin irritation. In addition, benzoyl peroxide can cause bleaching of the hair and of fabric. So it can bleach, you know, the patient's bedding, their clothes, their towels, that type of thing. Then we have tretinoin, which is a topical agent that stimulates the turnover of epithelial cells. Side effects of tretinoin include photosensitivity as well as skin irritation. You definitely want to teach your patient to wear sunscreen when they go out because of that side effect of photosensitivity. Then we have an oral medication that is used to treat severe acne, which is isotretinoin. So isotretinoin works by inhibiting sebaceous gland function. Side effects include chylitis, which is like cracking and dryness at like the corners of the mouth. It can also cause dry skin as well as photosensitivity. So with this medication, you are also gonna want to advise your patient to wear sunscreen and also use skin moisturizers because of the side effect of dry skin. The other key thing about this medication is that it definitely causes birth defects. So it's gonna be really important that your patient not use this when pregnant. And in fact, they make every patient, every female of childbearing age, take two pregnancy tests prior to treatment with this medication, and they make them follow up with pregnancy tests every single month. And so my son is on this medication for his acne. If you look at the, you know, at the pill container, like the blister pack, on top of every pill is a picture of a pregnant woman with a big line through it. So they are not messing around when it comes to making sure you are not pregnant when taking isotretinoin. So that's definitely a key point when it comes to this medication. The last medication I want to cover in this video is permethrin, which is used to treat pediculosis, which is a fancy name for lice, as well as scabies. So if you stay till the end of this video, I'm gonna give you a little story about lice and permethrin. So definitely hang in there for that. So this medication works by paralyzing the nervous system of the insects. Side effects are minimal and can include skin irritation. If your patient has lice, they will need to shampoo with 1% permethrin, and then afterwards they should use a special nit comb to make sure they remove all the nits from the head. So nits are lice eggs. For scabies, the patient will need to apply permethrin from head to toe and leave it on for 8 to 14 hours. And it's advised that the entire household be treated for scabies if one person has scabies. In order to prevent reinfestation, you want to provide teaching to your patient. So they should wash all of their clothes and linens in hot water. For items that cannot be washed, they need to put them in a bag and seal that bag and keep it in there for at least 2 weeks. So my little story about pediculosis or lice is that when my daughter was 5, and this was a long time ago because she's 20 now, she was going to bed and she's like, "Mom, my head's kind of itchy." And I'm like, "All right, well, let me take a look." And I looked and there was like 3 generations of lice living on her head, like big guys and medium ones and little baby ones. I mean, so many lice. It was a little traumatizing. So anyway, we treated it with permethrin shampoo. I used that Nick comb and I took hours to go through every millimeter of her head to get rid of those nits and any remaining lice. And of course, during this whole like time where I'm like washing linens in hot water and treating her head, etc., my head's itchy. Like, I'm convinced I have lice. My head is so itchy. And I go to my husband, I'm like, "Can you please check my head?" And my husband is an amazing guy, but he's like, "Oh yeah, no, it looks good. I don't see anything." And I'm like, "No, dude, you gotta go through like every piece of my head. Like, you can't just look at it like that." Anyway, I wasn't really satisfied with his assessment skills. So I went to my daughter's preschool director and she did a thorough assessment on my head. Luckily did not have lice. But it was definitely a stressful time with that whole, pediculosis. And luckily I haven't had to go through that again since then. If you have a story about lice or scabies, be sure to leave it in the comments because I definitely want to see that. All right, time for a quiz. I have 3 questions for you. First question: what topical acne treatment can cause bleaching of the hair and fabrics? The answer is benzoyl peroxide. Question number 2, what key teaching do you need to provide a patient who uses topical tretinoin? The answer is you need to advise them to wear sunscreen or avoid sun exposure. Question number 3, what assessment do you need to do before providing a patient with oral isotretinoin? The answer is you need to run a pregnancy test. And in fact, you're going to need 2 negative pregnancy tests from the patient before they start therapy. And then you will need monthly pregnancy tests while they're on therapy. All right, that is it for this video. I hope this video has been helpful. This is actually the end of our entire pharmacology video playlist as well. So I hope you learned a lot and I hope these videos have helped you. If so, be sure to leave me a message and definitely tell your classmates and friends in nursing school about our channel. Thank you so much for watching. I invite you to subscribe to our channel and share a link with your classmates and friends in nursing school. If you found value in this video, be sure to hit the like button and leave us a comment and let us know what you found particularly helpful.